Hi friends, welcome back to Hobby Plus. Today I am going to discuss the active clamp circuit. Look at this. At first we have to know how many active clamps we have. So active clamp are two types. One is higher side active clamp, another is lower side active clamp. This circuit is higher side active clamp. Now I will discuss how this clamp circuit is work. First of all, that is your flyback converter. How can I identify this output? Because this diode in forward bias, this is your capacitor, load capacitor or filter capacitor. That means it is flyback converter. There is some other converter, that is forward bias converter. I will discuss everything later about forward bias converter, but today I discuss the clamp circuit. Look at this. That is your virtual capacitor, which is not physically connected in this circuit, so I cannot connect directly here. I connect it with a dot line. Actually this capacitor inside this switch, that is your n channel MOSFET, and that is also your n-channel MOSFET. Suppose when you on this circuit, 310 volt come here and this switch also on, so through this path goes to ground. In that time your transformer build up energy. When this switch is off, then this power, this energy convert to secondary, and you can get voltage output of the secondary of this transformer. But ringing also started. Now when your ringing start, that means ringing voltage through this capacitor, through this diode, goes to C1 capacitor and charge the capacitor. But in that moment this switch is off. There is a pulse which is applied on the gate of the clamp MOSFET. It is more higher than this frequency. So when it is off, that means in 0 point, that means this MOSFET is off. Power goes to capacitor through this diode, because this diode in this moment, this diode in forward bias, so power can go through this way. But when this pulse goes to 12 volt, that means this MOSFET is on, so capacitor discharge through this MOSFET and resonate with this coil, second primary coil of the transformer, and transfer the power to the secondary. More than 3 times 5 times, if we switching this MOSFET, we can get more power, but without use the source voltage. That means ringing part use here to transfer, to convert a power. That is your ringing part you get here. But if you use this clamp, you can use the ringing as a secondary power. So it is more efficient and easy to design. But one more thing, when we design the circuit, we have to use a different frequency. One frequency is here, another frequency is here. Now you have to understand what is the difference between this frequency. See that is your 200 kilohertz frequency and that is your 40 kilohertz frequency. That means when you drive your MOSFET through this frequency and you get some power output of the transformer, but when you use this frequency, that means 200 kilohertz, you can get more power and also suppressed your ringing. So that is the benefit of this circuit. When this is in ringing condition, that means your output of this transformer in ringing condition, this ringing voltage is going to high, so it stored in this capacitor, that is your clamp capacitor. After that you use this voltage which is stored in the C1 for better output or more higher output of the output section. So that is your benefit. And also this capacitor also resonate with this primary coil of the transformer, so you can get fresh and zero level switching transistor each and every cycle. That is the benefit. Now you can ask me or you can think, how can I make this two type of pulse in the same circuit? It is very easy and simple. First of all, you see this, that is your pulse B and that is your pulse A. Now what is the frequency? One is 200 kilohertz, another is 40 kilohertz. That means 5 times higher than base frequency. Now come here, that is your signal generator, you know, and there is two output A and output B. If you set this frequency as 200 kilohertz, then you get one pulse from the output A, 200 kilohertz, and output B also give you 200 kilohertz. But if you use here frequency divided circuit, I mention here IC number also, CD4017, it is a frequency divided IC. You can divide the output frequency, that is your, you get here, and you divide this frequency by 5, then you get 40 kilohertz frequency. In the same circuit you can get different type of frequency for your better use, and in this way you can use your clamping circuit in that way. I think you understand everything. If you have any other question or you have any other suggestion or any doubts, please tell me in my comment box. I will clear your doubt. And you know what to do. Please do this. Thank you. Thank you for watching.